So here at MIT, we do fusion research, fusion energy, and we do this fusion energy research at the Plasma Science and Fusion Center. So break that down a little bit. We'll look at plasmas and fusion. So first, let's talk about a plasma. So some people say it's a fourth state of matter or an ionized gas. So if you have a solid, you have atoms that are stuck really close together. You heat it up a little bit, you get a liquid. The atoms start to roll around. You heat it up more, you get a gas. So the atoms are flying around now. You take a gas and you heat it up even more, you get a plasma. And what a plasma is a gas that's so hot, the electrons actually come out of the atom, and you separately have positively charged nuclei, or ions, and negatively charged electrons flying around. So when we say an ionized gas or plasma, that's what we mean. And how hot is really hot? It's something about 10,000 Kelvin, or 10,000 degrees Celsius. So pretty hot is what we're talking about for a plasma. What is a plasma? What do we see? All stars are plasmas. Lightning is a plasma. Fluorescent light bulbs actually have a little bit of plasma in them. Even the northern lights, the aurora borealis, are little plasmas that we can see here on Earth. I'll also talk about fusion. So what is fusion? It's a form of nuclear energy. But when you think of today's nuclear power plants, those are all fission. So you have big atoms like uranium or plutonium. You split them apart, you get a bunch of energy. Fusion is the opposite. You take small atoms like hydrogen, you smash them together, you make a bigger atom like helium, and you get a bunch of energy out of that. And fusion is how the sun generates energy. It's how all stars generate energy. And so how are plasmas and fusion related? Well, in order to get these two atoms to fuse together, you have to make them smash into each other really hard. They have to go really fast. And if you talk macroscopically, going really fast means making something really hot. And so anything you make hot enough to do fusion is going to be a plasma. But not just a normal plasma, not 10,000 Kelvin. It's going to be something like 100 million Kelvin, so hotter than the core of the sun. Why do we want to do fusion? Well, there's a bunch of potential advantages. It's a carbon-free energy source. The fuel is basically seawater and lithium, so you can, there's thousands or maybe even millions of years of worth of fuel here on Earth. There's no risk of meltdown the same way you get for fission, and there's no radioactive byproducts the same way you get for fission. The downside is it doesn't quite work yet, but that's what we're studying here at MIT. We're doing our best to study plasmas, to study fusion energy, and to hopefully construct the next generation of fusion power plants. My name is Alex Creely, and I'm a fourth-year PhD student in the Department of Nuclear Science and Engineering, and I study plasma turbulence and transport with Professor Ann White.